If you ever you think that you want to kill us, you can kill us in a place where there is no earth, where there is no water, there is no air, there is no fire, there is no ether, there is no mind, there is no intelligence, there is no ego. You can kill us in that spot. So that means they can't be killed anywhere within the universe. That's what they were thinking. And they didn't know anything beyond the universe because they were demons. So then Vishnu started fighting with them. The fight went on for a long time. When the fight is going on, Brahma was sweating again because the whole evil atmosphere created by Madhu and Kaitava. And again the sweat came. This time with the sweat came a small entity and it was on his feet. He was moving around there and he said, "What is this?" And he looked at it. Then it started growing, so it threw it on the floor. And it grew more. It was a dart. Brahma said, "Oh, that's..." Because no species are present at that time. "What is this? Black dart with so much hair on the body. And grew, became so big and so strong." Spoke in Sanskrit. This is for the information of Darwin. He is so confused. Here is a dark speaking Sanskrit. And he spoke with Brahma. So he said, "You have created me, so where will I go?" So Brahma said, "I created something without my knowledge." So he said, "You go to Jambunada." There was one piece of land in the water of dissolution, Jambunada Kshetra. So you go to Jambunada. So immediately he entered Jambunada and he sat down there and he was looking. And what he saw was Madhu and Kaitava fighting. And he was clapping his hands and he was whistling and he said, "Ah, wonderful, hit him on the head." And he was the audience. And Vishnu was fighting in the sky and going up and coming down and taking them and throwing them. And they were also not less strong. They were coming from the ear of Vishnu. They were so strong. They were giving a good fight. Garbhoda said Vishnu was lying down for a long time, you know. Brahma was looking, going into the stem, coming out of the stem. He got bored. So he wanted to have some entertainment. So he created somebody and started fighting. If he has to have some good time, he has to create some demons and fight with them. So then finally he said, "Ah, it's too late." So he took Madhu and Kaitava and kept them on his lap. And then with his hand he crushed them. They were finished. Because there is no earth, water, fire, ether, air, mind, intelligence and ego. This is transcendental body. So they were finished. And Jambavan jumped up and down and he said, "Wonderful, wonderful fight. Can I see any more?" So Vishnu said, "You wait for the creation to start." Creation is not started yet. Then there will be so many nice fights. So then the creation started. And then the Manvantaras came one by one. There was a great dissolution. Satyavrata was on the boat. This golden fish came, huge big fish with a horn. And with Vasuki, the snake, they tied the fish's horn with that boat. And there were the Sapta Rishis there, and Jambavan was there, sitting there, looking at it. And he said, "Ah, what a nice fish." And he circumvented the fish. And the fish was circumvating the whole universe. And this way Jambavan had a good engagement at that time. Because if Jambavan will not die, he has no death. He is a Chiranjeevi. So he will always be there. So he was getting old, but he was quite strong. And then Purma avatar came, he witnessed that also. Raha avatar, he witnessed that. Hiranyaksha getting slapped. When Hiranyaksha was slapped, Hiranyaksha went up, circling like this. And while he was coming back, his eyeballs came out of his socket. And Jambavan was playing with them. He was saying, "Ah, what a wonderful fight." And then that was finished, and Nishinga avatar, he saw that also. Then he saw Bamandev. Then Vamandev grew into a huge big figure, lifting his leg and piercing the universe from the top. Jambavan, with 6 minutes, he circled this great form of Trivikrama 18 times. That was the speed of Jambavan. And he was in ecstasy. Aha, what a beautiful form. And he was going round and round, round and round, round and round, 18 times within 6 moments. 6 moments. Can you go around this 6 moments? You cannot. He was going around that beautiful form, the transcendental Vishwarup of the Lord. And while he was coming back, And he was so much in excess, he was lying down like this, and he scratched Mount Meru with his toenails. And Meru got all upset. Meru Savarni, he came in person. He said, "Oh, you dirty bat. What are you doing to me? Touch me with your foot. Even the Sapta Rishis, they don't touch me. They float over me. They don't touch with their foot. And you have to do this? So you become old." He cursed him. "Because you are young. And you are so fast, you are offending me. And you become so old, and you become very weak." So Jambavan became very old. And then Meru Savarni told him that though you are old, when the passions of Lord Ramachandra come, you will do a lot of service for him. And this was Jambavan. And this Jambavan was called by Sugriva. And he told Jambavan, "You are the older. There is nothing that you don't know. There is no avatar that you have not seen. There is no demigod that you don't know. There is no ocean that you don't know. You know everything in this creation. So you must help Angada. Angada is the son of Bali. You must help him. Find out where Sita is." So Jambavan said, "Yes." He told Angada, "Don't worry. I cannot fly like before, but I know every place. And I will be your tour guide in your South Indian tour. Somehow we will find Mother Sita." So then there was Nila. Nila was also Brahmaputra. He was the mental son of Brahma. And he is an engineer. And he is also a chemist. And he is a scientist. A great scientist. And who is Nila? Nila is also a bear. And it's a bear scientist. So this scientist, he could float stones, he could reduce the density of stone, he could increase the density of stone. He was such a physicist, and he was also a chemist. He could take different things and mix them up and make different wonderful effects of color and smell and different feelings. He could change the feelings by his chemical mix-up. He will take something and mix with something, you will put it and you will feel miserable. Something else, you will get changed, then you will feel happy. Something else you will put on, you will feel angry. Even you will change your mind by chemicals. It's not before taking, just outside. These scientists are giving it inside, but he will just keep it outside and change your mood. He was such a great chemist. This is described in the Vishnu Purana, Nila's exploit. And he constructed this kingdom in Kishkindha, which was so strong. It was complete stone, and there was no cement, no concrete. The stone on top of stone. And the way they are kept, because he knows all the physics rules, the way they are kept over one over another, they are holding each other like a huge big palace. And it's very strong. So this is Nila. And Hanuman, Jambavan, Nila, and Angada, they all step forward with this 30,000 vanaras. They looked everywhere. They couldn't find. Then they were coming to the Vindhya mountain. Under the Vindhya mountain, by the time they crossed the forest, which had no leaves, those trees are there, only branches. Because one rishi's son, he cursed the forest, that you will become barren. So many trees are there, but there is no leaves. And no leaves means no flowers, it means no fruit. That means all the monkeys are hungry. They had been already about 3 weeks with no water and no food. They didn't know what to do. And they saw this black cave in front of the Vindhya mountain. So Hanuman, he said to Angada, that we are great warriors, so we must have some thrill. Let us enter this cave. And all the monkeys said, no, we are not going inside this cave. Already there is no water, there is no food. Now you go inside, there will be no light. And then you go deeper, there will be no air. Then we can all die. So Hanuman said, "All right, whoever wants to go, raise your hand." So Jambavan, Nila, Angada, Hanuman, of course, and then a few other monkeys, they all raised their hand. And then Hanuman said, "All right, hold my tail." So Angada was holding his tail, and Nila was holding Angada's tail, and Jambavan was in the middle because they didn't want to lose the old man, old bear. He was in the middle. And then there were other monkeys, and they slowly started walking into this dark cave. And the only symptom they saw was some birds were coming from inside. and their wings were wet. So Hanuman said, look, these birds are wet. That means some water is there. And if the birds are coming from inside the cave, that means some people must be living there. Must be a nice place. So everyone should come. And he was preaching. So they were all one by one joining, and a few were standing and thinking what to do. And they thought that Angada and Jambavan and they are all going, and we are standing here. There is no water here. And they are the only protection for us. Now they are also gone. What we will do here? So they also decided to join. So all the monkeys joined. They all went inside the cave. And after crossing 80 miles inside the cave in complete darkness, and every 5 minutes Jambavan was shouting the names of all the monkeys, just to check that everyone was there. It was so dark, you can't see anything. And finally they were coming, there was a gleam of light coming. And Hanuman shouted, Ram, 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 oh, there is light here, there must be some people over there who will get some food, they're hungry monkeys. So they all came in there and they saw there was a beautiful city inside the cave. And so many mansions were there. These mansions were all made with gold and ruby and diamond. I couldn't believe their eyes. Then there was lakes there, lotus flowers, nice creepers and fruits. And then Angada said, don't believe this. This may be the work of some demon. And as soon as we go inside, he will swallow us. Don't touch anything. Keep leaping. So they were leaping from one place to another place. Then they leaped into a mansion. And without making any sound, they were inside. They were looking. They found one woman who was dressed in tiger skin and with matted locks of hair. She was having a trident in her hand. He said, what is this? She looks like a Babaji. And here is this wonderful palace. So Hanuman went in front and he folded his hands. Hanuman is very good in talking. So he folded his hands and he gave a smile. And then he said, please tell us who you are. Look at this, very spiritually advanced person. Flattered. Then he said, I hope you are not a demon. But you don't look like one, you look very pious. So you must tell us who you are. So she said, first you tell me who you are. How did you ever come inside this place? This is a mystic place. Human beings, Gandharvas, Vanaras, they can never come here. Only celestials can come here. And Jambavan was murmuring, yeah, they are all celestials only. They look like monkeys. Then Angada said, what did you say? Jambavan said, no, I'm just telling something old. Because he has taken part in Ram's pastimes many times. And every time they have gone in search of Sita. And every time they are gone into the cave also. For him it's nothing new. But still it is thrill. Because it is the last pastime. It's not boring. So every time he sees something like that, he will swear because he couldn't keep it. He has seen it many times. And they are seeing it for the first time because the demigods keep changing. But Jambavan is the same Jambavan. So anyway, Hanuman said that we are all servants of Lord Ramachandra, who is the son of Dasarath. Then he said, see, Ramachandra, I don't think he is the son of an earthly king. Because otherwise, how just by chanting his name, you could cross that dark cave? It is not possible for anyone to do that. So then she said, this must be an incarnation of Vishnu. So he said, he is the Supreme Lord. So then Jambavan said, he also knows so much. I also know this. It's an incarnation of the Supreme Lord. And I also know we will find Sita. Then some monkeys heard it. What did you say? No, it's just telling some old things. You don't listen to me. I always murmur like this. Old people like to murmur like that. So anyway, Hanuman and this lady got into some good conversation and Hanuman pleased her. And she told her identity that she is a friend of Hema and Hema is the daughter of Meru, Mount Meru. And this Hema was kept there as a captive by one great demon called Mayasura. He was a great magician. And Indra came and he sent his Vajra and he finished this demon Maya. And he took charge of Hema. So Hema became Indra's wife. And Hema was alone in that huge, big magical city. So Indra requested Meru to send his daughter so that they can have some association. And Hema has gone out somewhere, and that is why this lady is there. And she is an ascetic, and she believes in worship of impersonal Brahman and Mukti, so she is there with tiger skin and trident. This was the story. So then Hanuman said, we are very hungry and we are monkeys, and you please give us something to eat. So she said, no problem, why, you can go into this garden and you can eat plenty of fruit, you fill your stomach. So the whole army went into this garden, beautiful garden of Mayapur, and they ate stomach full. And then they came to drink the water. And after drinking the water, she supplied them with wine. They also took some wine, some grape juice, a little sour grape juice. Not that bad wine like the wine of today. Doesn't intoxicate you. But wine of those days is just like a drink. Like the Indian version of Coca-Cola. Little sour. And this way they enjoyed nicely. And they came to her and they told, you please tell us how we can get out of the cave now. So she said, getting out of this cave? No. You can never get out of this cave. He said, what? You fed us nicely. You've given us so many nice drinks. Now you're sitting us in jail. So Hanuman took the club and he said, you want to see? So she said, well, you just ate in my house. You can't fight with me. I said, you cannot get out of the cave. I never said that you won't go out of the cave. You, all of you close your eyes. They all closed the eyes. Then she said, open your eyes. They opened the eyes and they were not there. They were outside. In front of them was this huge big ocean, Mahodadi. Mahodadi ocean. When you go to Puri, they will tell you this ocean's name is Mahodadi. This Mahodadi extends all the way up to Kanyakumari. So they were somewhere between Rameshwar and Puri. But this land extended so many miles down at that time in Treta Yuga. The Ceylon that we are seeing today, the Sri Lanka, that is not the same Sri Lanka. That Sri Lanka is further more down. Because 100 yojanas Hanuman flew. The yojana is 8 miles. 100 yojana is 800 miles. But from Rameshwar to Sri Lanka is not 800 miles. You can reach within 45 minutes by a boat. It's not that far. So this Sri Lanka is not the original Sri Lanka. And it is mentioned that they were on top of a mountain. From there Hanuman flew. And in the area of Rameshwaram, you don't find any mountain. So that area, from there Hanuman jumped, Gandhamadana Hills, that is very much down. And that is all eaten up by ocean. Anyway, we shouldn't think that in this bank of the ocean they were standing. That's why I'm telling you. They were miles down into the ocean at that time. Because the ocean comes up and eats the land. Even the scientists say that every year it is moving something, 7 centimeters or something. So in this way, erosion is there. And here, Hanuman and all of them, they saw this Mahodadi ocean. It was very fierce. And Angada, he looked at the ocean and he said, we have come to the end of the land. Where is Sita? We have not found her. And how can I go back? It is already 1 month. We started on full moon night, and this is full moon night. So Angada felt very bad. He said, bring some darba grass, some kusa grass. He put it with the tip facing towards north. And he was going to do a prayopavesa. Prayopavesa means when a great personality cannot accomplish some task that he has promised that he will do, he will leave his body by fasting. He will sit there on the kusa grass. So he was sitting on the kusadra. Hanuman was sitting like this, looking at the ocean. He was thinking, what is this? We have come to a blank disk. What is going on now? Should I go back or go front? And how go front? And Jambavan was taking rest because he was too tired after drinking wine and eating so much fruit. And then other few monkeys are walking around looking here and there. Then Hanuman looked here. Then he saw the monkeys and he said, what are you going to do? They said, we have a good idea. What? We will go back to the cave, plenty of fruit, plenty of wine. You cannot get out. If you cannot get out, you cannot get in. So nobody will come to trouble us. So we can be happy there. Hanuman said, ah, what a silly idea. Then they said, Prabhu, we need security. So he said, that is nonsense. It is Maya. You take the security from Krishna. You don't take security from somebody else. Lord Ramachandra is our Lord. And where you need security for? You want to take security in wine and fruit, you must be a monkey, and you are a monkey. And you chastise them. And then another child was Angada, he was sitting there chanting mantras, he's going to leave his bed. Kanuman came up there, Angada, you are a prince, what are you doing? Looking towards north on the Kusa grass, this is not meant for strong people. You look at your shoulder, it's so strong. And this is supposed to be for fighting for Lord Ramachandra. And here you are, fasting, going to die. You think you are Mahatma Gandhi or what? You didn't say that. I'm telling you. What are you going to accomplish by fasting? You will die. And everyone will say, the son of Bali, he is a useless monkey. He died because he couldn't accomplish his mission. So Angada said, you are talking all this, tall talk. But you tell me, what are we supposed to do? Sugriva, if I go back, he will kill me. And he will take the kingdom. Already he planned somehow to kill my father. And now he has got the reason to kill me. He will say, you didn't accomplish your mission, so I am killing you. And nobody will ask him anything, and he will have the kingdom. Let him have the kingdom even otherwise. Let me just die. At least he won't commit the sin. So then Hanuman, he thought that, oh, I have to use politics here. Because Sama, Dana, Beda, Danda, there are four ways of preaching. First you speak nice things, and then you offer something. I'll make you regional secretary, something like that. And then otherwise it doesn't work. And then you make a Beda, make a difference of opinion between the groups. You know what he told about you? Ah, he's speaking bad about you. And then you go on that side and say, he's speaking bad about you. And then you get from both sides some benefit. There are so many kinds of people in this world. You find them inside this can also. They do that. Hanuman thought that I have to do Beda now. So he came to him and he said, yes, yes, Sugriva is like that only. Now he may take the whole kingdom. But think of it, your mother is there. You are dying. Your mother will be having suffering there. She will give her no food, no cloth, no respect. She will beg in the street, your mother. What? I don't know. Took the kushagras through it. I'm not fasting, why should I fast? Sugriva should fast. Hanuman said, see, you must fast. And if you die, what is the benefit? You must go back now. Somehow or other, we will convince him that we couldn't find Sita. Then Angada said, oh, how will I go back? I have no strength. Hanuman said, you sit down. I will tell you the pastimes of Lord Ramachandra. Then you will gain strength. Then he started describing the pastimes of Ramachandra. And they discussed all these wonderful things of how Lord Ramachandra broke the bow and how Lord Ramachandra defeated Parasuram and how Lord Ramachandra caressed Jatayu and cremated him. And as soon as they were telling that, then they saw around, there was some change in the atmosphere. Everything was trembling and shaking. And Hanuman caught hold of Angada. Angada said, some demon is coming. They were looking there. And then from under the mountain side, Vindhya is this side and there is the Osat, the Mahodadi. And from that side, they saw two big feet coming out. They were looking like a bird's feet. And each nail or each stem of that five stems they have. So each stem of it was like about, nearly say in our calculation, about 2 kilometers. That long. And when they saw this, Angada said, that's it. All the 30,000 monkeys will be eaten by this bird demon now. Look at these fingers, they're so big. And then slowly, slowly they saw. And then they noted that this bird is not having any speech. Very slow. And it is dragging himself slowly, slowly like that. And then slowly they saw the wings also. The wings were 14. I'm not good in math. 14 yojanas long. One yojana is 8 miles. I leave it for the mathematician. So 14 yojanas long one side and 14 yojanas long on the other side. And these huge wings. But these wings were broken from the apparatus here. And they were all completely burned. They looked like charcoal. And he was dragging himself with great difficulty and then his face came out. Big beak. And then he was opening his beak and speaking. And speaking Sanskrit. There are so many such characters in Ramayana. And he was telling, who is talking about my brother Jatayu? And then so many monkeys flew up just by the air coming out of his mouth. He was so strong. So he weak now, but he is very strong. So then the monkeys were flying. And then Jambavan was called. Hanuman said, Jambavan, please take care of our monkeys. We will speak to this person. He must be useful to us. So they both came to him. And then they said, who are you? We are talking of Jatayu, and this is Angada and I am Hanuman. I am son of Vayu. And we are messengers of Ram. So then this bird slowly opened his eyes like this. And then he said, Ram? Is this the Ram, the son of Dasarath? He said, yes, the same Ram. Oh, he was exiled to the forest. And has he completed his exile? So Angada said, what a wonderful bird. Sitting under the mountain, cannot even move, and he knows history. So then Angada told him, yes, they are still in exile because they lost their wife. And Sita has been taken by Ravan. Then this bird said, Ravan, oh, I will eat him up. So then Hanuman said, oh, very good, please do it. He said, but I can't fly, my wings are broken. I am Sampati, I am the elder brother of Jatayu. I am much stronger than Jatayu. And I heard that Jatayu is killed by that Ravana. Oh, I want to kill him. Then he said, oh, I can't kill him because I entered into an agreement with him. Long ago, when Sampati was flying, when he was young and very strong, Ravan was flying with somebody's wife. He always does this. This time it is Ramachandra's wife. But he always took anybody's wife. Once he was making a fire sacrifice, and Agni came there to give him blessing, and he took Agni's wife. So Ramachandra is famous for taking people's wife. So Sampati stopped him and he said, oh, where are you going? Who is this woman? So he said, oh, this is Nalakutera's wife, and I'm taking her to Kailas. So he said, you better leave her on right now on the spot where I am going, so she will be safe. Otherwise, you don't know what I will do to you. So Ravana said, ah, you are just a dirty bird. Said, all right. So he took one of his feet and then caught hold of Ravan like this and crushed him. And blood came out of Ravan's body. That is why Ravan has got 5 holes in his body from somebody's nails. So 5 holes in his body, which he covers up with some other arrangements so that nobody can see it. But 1 hole in his chest he doesn't cover. That is the horn of the Airavata, the tusk of Airavata elephant. It's a big hole on the chest. That he wants to show because that great fighting thing. But a bird made hole in his body is not good. So he covers it with chadar and everything, trying to do makeup. So Sampati, at that time Ravana touched his feet. And he said, please, though you are a bird, I touch your feet. You please make an agreement with me. And I won't come in your area. I won't do anything there, any wrong there. And you don't please come in my area. So they signed an agreement. Like Reagan and Gorbachev. So don't come to Lanka. He said, all right, don't come to this area. Because of this, Sampati is bound by dharma. Then Sampati, how he became old like this? Hanuman asked that. So Sampati told, but once we were having a competition, Jatayu and me, and we were flying. We're flying higher and higher and higher and higher and higher like that. But then what happened, we came very close to the sun. And I saw Jatayu was burning. So to cover him, I put my wings over him. But I was so close to the sun, and my wings got burnt. And then they also got loose, and I fell down here. And after that, I don't know where my brother went. Only now I am listening from you that he has died in the service of Lord Ramachandra. And he said that I have been staying here for so long, and the Rishi told me that when I will tell you where Sita is, at that time I will get my strength back. Then Hanuman heard that, what did you say? Can I tell you where Sita is? Where Sita is? And they started jumping up and down, all the monkeys. Oh, Sita, we found Sita, we found Sita. So then Sampati told, can you please move me out of this cave? I can't come so much. I have to climb on top of the India to look at it. Then Angada said, look at what? So look at Lanka. Angada said, look at Lanka, it is 800 miles away. So then Hanuman came close to Angada and he said, you just look at this bird. It's so big, so huge, 14 yojanas this way, 14 yojanas. This bird itself is about 30 yojanas long. And can you imagine how much power the eyes will be? He can sit here and see Ravan, what kind of cosmetics he is using. So with great difficulty, all the monkeys came under Sampati and moved him out. 30,000 monkeys were trying so hard It was difficult for them to somehow put him on top of a rock with his wings like this. And then he lifted his beak and he started looking. And he said, I can see Sri Lanka. And he said, I can see the 10th-floor building of Ravana. He said, I can see the roof. He said, I can see Ravana standing on the top. He could see everything. Such a powerful eyesight. The eagles, even the normal eagles, when they are up there, they can see the fish. The shelterer come down, pick up the fish and go away. This is the ordinary eagle. So Sampadi, who is the son of Aruna, Aruna is the charioteer, we had his pastime yesterday. Aruna became Aruni, same Aruna. This is Aruna's son. So he must be very powerful. So he saw that and he said, I cannot see Sita. Then he looked, then he said, but Ravan is walking here and there. Then he said, so many demons are around. Then he came down. I can see a forest with Ashoka trees. Then he said, I can see a yellow cloth hanging there. As soon as I said yellow cloth, Hanuman said, yes, yellow cloth. That is what Mother Sita was wearing. Because she took some ornaments and she put them in a yellow cloth that she was wearing, showed the piece of sari, and she threw it down. And Hanuman has picked it up before Ramachandra came to his kingdom. And Lakshmana has identified them that these are Sita's jewelry. So Hanuman became very happy. And even when they were looking, slowly, Sampadi's wings came straight. And new feathers started coming out of his body. And then next moment they heard a big Ram. Sampadi chanted, Ram. And when he started Ra, already he rose up in the sky. And by the time they heard the Ram, they saw him as a point in the higher sky. He disappeared, flew away. This way Sampadi went to the heavenly planet. He didn't want to be there because he was so exalted to go and kill Ravan, but he has signed the pact and he can't do it. So he just helped them and he has gone. So now they all found out that Sita is there in Sri Lanka. So Hanuman was asked by Jambavan. Jambavan told him, you must leap over this ocean and you must go. So Hanuman said, this ocean is so big, how will I do that? Then Jambavan told Hanuman his own pastimes. That how he got the sun planet inside his mouth. So now as Jambavan was telling, Hanuman's body started growing. He was becoming bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. And he became so big that Valmiki says that his shadow was 50 yojanas long. He became so huge and all the monkeys were like mosquitoes in front of him. Then he told Jambavan, yes, I am the servant of Ram and I am the son of Vayu. He said, nobody can stop me. I will crush Ravan with my thumb and I will bring Sita on my shoulder. No necessity for Ramachandra to go. I am going now. And he said, Ram. He started with Ra and he ended with him. And when he said him, he was in Sri Lanka. He was that quick. And he took the path that Lord Shiva travels. Of course he would. If he is Lord Shiva's Ansha. There are different heights in the sky that the demigods travel. Gandharvas travel very close to earth, which is very far from our jet lines travel space. And then after Gandharvas come Kinnaras, after Kinnaras come Vanaras, and after Vanaras come Siddhas, after Siddhas come Taranas, and after the Taranas come the bigger demigods like Ganesh or Kartikeya and so many wonderful Kailas members. And then comes Lord Shiva's track. In that area nobody flies. It is owned by Rudra, it is his zone. And there he went. And he was flying fearlessly. Why he should fear? Because he is servant of Lord Ramachandra. In this way, simply by chanting Ram, only once, Hanuman reached Sri Lanka. Before reaching Sri Lanka, he encountered many disturbances on the way. Disturbances were also there, help also was there. There was one mountain called Mainaka Parvata, which can grow simply by thinking. The ocean king told Mainaka Parvata, Hanuman is coming, the servant of Ram, he must take some rest. And he is sleeping in one bridge. So you must grow up and give him some rest. So Mayapur Parvat grew up to the sky and it stopped Hanuman. Hanuman was coming like this. And he said, what is this? There was no mountain here. And he asked him, who are you? Because Hanuman can speak not only from his mouth. He can speak from any hole of his body. This is his yogic perfection. And he had only one breath, so he didn't open his mouth. He was still carrying Ra. Because Im has to be pronounced only in Sri Lanka. So he was talking through some other hole of his body. And Mayapur Parvat was wondering, this is a wonderful teacher. a monkey with a long tail speaking through the holes of the body. So Mayanaka said, please put your lotus feet on my head because I have to show to the ocean king that I have served you. Hanuman said, no rest when I am doing Krishna service. I am going. So then the demigods, they said, hey, this is not correct. He simply reaches there. There must be some fun. So they called the great snake called Sarasa. And this Sarasa was ordained to go and stop Hanuman. The Sarasa took the form of a demon. She came in there. She opened her mouth. And Hanuman was flying and he was growing up like this and big mouth was open like a churn. So Hanuman said, please move away from here. I am on the Lord's mission. Sarasa said, no. Brahma has given me a benediction that unless somebody goes into my mouth, you cannot pass by this way. So Hanuman said, oh, but this mouth is too small for me. And he started growing more. So she started growing more. Opening the mouth wider and wider and wider. He started growing and she started growing and he was growing and growing and she was growing and growing and so her mouth became as big as half of the universe. At that time Hanuman suddenly became small and he entered the mouth and came out. Then he said, see, I have defeated you. I entered your mouth, I have come out. Now you please bless me. So she gave blessing. And then he was going. And then another Simhamukhi, one great demoness son, she said that, she didn't swallow you, but I must swallow you. She came in there. She also did the same thing. Hanuman asked her also the same. You please open the mouth little more wider so that you can eat me comfortably. She opened the mouth more wider. Hanuman became small. And though he became small, the strength is same. So he went inside the mouth like that and he hit the back of her mouth. And by the hitting, blood came out and he died. She died. And then Hanuman got her blessings too. While she was dying, he said, she was some Gandharva woman. There are many stories like this. They were cursed and they became demons. So she got very happy and said, I am killed by Hanuman. Now I will get liberation. So she blessed Hanuman. He said, there is one more person you have to kill at the entrance of the gate. So Hanuman landed in Sri Lanka. Then he looked at the Lanka, beautiful city. And he was feeling very dark. What a beautiful city in the hand of a demon. Why is he having it? And he was making his mind, before I go from here, I will destroy this city somehow or other. When he came in there, there was Lankini sitting there, the great demoness with the trident. So Hanuman became a small monkey, very small monkey, only that big. And he was running inside the gate. So she was sitting there and said, well, you are not going. Hanuman said, oh, this is very intelligent. I'm so small and she found me. So he climbed over her hand and came on her shoulder. He looked at her and he said, I'm a small monkey, please let me in. I want to eat some fruits. So he said, fruits? What fruits you are going to eat? He said, I heard there are beautiful mangoes and Ravana is keeping them only for himself. So then she said, I will get you any mango outside this gate. There are so many gardens in there you can eat. For fruit, why you are going inside? So then Hanuman said, don't waste my time. You better let me in. What? Sitting on my shoulder. You don't know who I am. I am Lankini. Hanuman said, hey, you're Lankini. I will slap you. You will slap me. You cannot reach my cheek. So he said, please take me to your cheek. So she took Hanuman to kept him on her cheek. And then he gave a slap. With the slap, she fell down and blood came out of her mouth. Though he was so small, because strength is strength. His murti is small, but his kirti is so big. And then he went inside. And then what he did inside, how he saw the wonderful queens of Ravana, and how he mistook Mandodari to be Sita, then how he talked with Sita, all these wonderful stories we'll have tomorrow. It's already time up now. Ramachandra Bhagavan ki, Hanuman ki, Jai Gautam Mandir.